Good morning. Oh, happy good morning. Monday.
Buenos dias. Come on, Kevin. You got to get up and do it.
Yeah, what's this little shimmy shake that you got going on?
Oh.
You said it's like a famous dance, right?
It is a famous dance all over the place, all over the world, like big artists and everybody's like playing that.
Well, you said TikTok, and that's where you lost me, Daniel. I don't do TikTok.
Oh, man. What's wrong with you? Where do you live?
I'm an Instagrammer type of guy. I feel like you got to pick between both of them. We can't all be both.
Yeah, you can.
All right. Well, I'm going to have to investigate
the best of both worlds. But also true on Instagram and other platforms.
So how was your weekend, my man?
It was good.
Good. It was a good weekend. Watched some interesting basketball. Went to a little man's car show.
Oh, nice. How was that?
It was amazing. A lot of great vendors, great cars, and just great cars. Like, that's one thing definitely. Loretta Beef Jerky, they put on an amazing show.
They always do. They always do.
A lot of our vendors were there, members. Great to see people. It's always like the thing that I love about the chambers, no matter where you go, it's almost like a little homecoming get together with like friends.
Right. Yes. No, it was good. I had the chance on Saturday to go and take care of my kid back with his mom.
Yeah, you said there, so. Hit a little bit of snow on the way, but not too bad of
not
traffic.
Not too bad, yes. It was really good. Almost nothing, just kind of Las Vegas, kind of like that. But everything else was really good. Good ride.
That's good. Well, and a special thank you to Josh and Eddie from Motion Bound for breakfast burritos from Golden Pride today.
Yes.
They even get Daniel's order right.
My special. So that's good. That's awesome.
Like everybody picks a number, Daniel makes his own custom.
So really good.
So thank you
so
much.
Thank you. We really appreciate it. So yeah, let's start with the new members for last week.
Yeah.
All right. So we're going to start with MRico Consulting with Mario Rico, Sandia Sunroof, Jeff Poole, Minuteman Press, Don Dulac, HHC Supply with Olivia Gutierrez, and then Sandia Shine Company with Santiago Trujillo. Sandia Shine Company is actually detailing for your vehicles, and this guy do like a really, really good job. He just like high quality products for, you know, detailing out your vehicles, and he's mobile.
So in the weather that we've had, I think everybody probably needs to get their cars washed.
Yeah. So mobile, so he can go to your office, your car can be detailed while you're working. So taking care of two things at the same time. That's awesome. Ooh, what was that? And then someone got excited about it. And then we have Chevron with Patrick Killen. Chevron and Patrick, thank you so much and all your team for all your continued support with the Chamber, big sponsor for the gala, and they keep continuing sponsoring other events and getting more and more involved with your community. So thank you for all that. And we have Mann's Construction Company with Frank Torres.
Yeah, thank you all. Welcome. We're excited to see you at upcoming events. Things like that, and being a resource for you with the chamber. And then we want to go ahead and thank a couple renewing members. This is one of my favorites because 1997 they've been a member.
Wow.
Diana Chocon. Chocon. Mm-hmm. New Mexico Beef Council, Primetime Publishing LLC, Dana Benjamin, member since 2022. Question Construction, Tina Cordova, member since 2006. Love seeing that 2006 as well. Otis Elevator Company, Nichol, Brevig, member since 2011. Albuquerque, Bernalillo County Water Utility Authority. Stan, member since 2017. Village of Los Ranchos, Mayor Don Lopez. Wasn't he in here the other day?
Yes, he came in the other day.
Got to meet you the other day. You've been a member since 2021. Great guy, super down to earth. Paulson Plumbing and Mechanical, Paulette Baca, member since 2013. And Authentic Web Solutions, Carla Fisher, member since 2022. Thank you all for our new members, and thank you for our continued members. We couldn't be a chamber without you.
Yes, and also, too, like, just real quick, with Mayor Don Lopez, we're trying, like, talking about working on an initiative for the village of Albuquerque and all the business in 4th Street and things like that. So there's a lot of things coming in, so just keep an eye on that.
Yeah, and then we have a lot of events coming up, which is exciting for us, and I think it's going to be exciting for all of you guys. So I'll go ahead and let Daniel kick it off with what's going on tomorrow.
So tomorrow we have a great event. We have a great panel here, and it's actually like a workshop that we're having, and it is hosted by the New Mexico Public Relations Society for America. And so there's going to be like three powerful women coming in. Three powerful women giving a talk about the importance of PR, public relations, because everything that we do is relates to PR. You know, when you're selling, when you're presenting a product, a service, it doesn't matter if it's for a nonprofit organization, a government branch, any kind of business, PR is always attached to it. It's how you present, how you talk to people, the ways how you communicate, how you express, and things like that. So PR is really important. A lot of people don't take attention into that. So that's going on tomorrow here. It's called Cookies, Constructions, and Cultivo. Again, this powerful lady is the panelist that we're going to have.
Yeah, some impressive women in business for any state, but it's amazing they're for our state.
And so. They are like great leaders. So we
They're great leaders in our community and for their companies.
Yeah, so we have Rebecca Leitam with the CEO of Girl Scouts of New Mexico Trails. We have Carla Kugler, President CEO of the Associated Builders Construction of New Mexico.
And then one of our favorites, Roberta Ritchie, CXO.
Yes.
Woo, woo.
Go, Roberta! So she's going to be there. And then what else?
On the 29th, the next day, we have our Biz Gratis Explorer from 5:30 to 7:30. Last we checked, we have about 112 people already registered and signed up to go.
So it's going to be a good
one. If you're
not
registered yet, go ahead and get registered. Come on out. Explore. It's basically the funnest place in Albuquerque, arguably. Like,
and we get to play and network.
It's going to be an amazing time.
I should say, we get to work and network, right? I'm playing.
Work first, play second.
Yes. And also, too, so we're having a ribbon cutting.
We have two of them, two ribbon cuttings on Saturday.
So one of them is going to be the Hydro Bar 7400 Montgomery with Tim. So that one is going to be at 11, right?
Yeah, that's going to be at 11 a.m. And then after that, we have, it's a Easter block party.
It's going to be fun.
Put on by Belle or Belen, depending on her preferred preference. She goes by both. And that's going to be 145 Eubank Boulevard near Central and Eubank. That one's going to have food trucks, DJs, performances, and more. Every booth that's going to be there is going to give out free goodies to kids, ensuring they all have a full Easter basket.
Yeah, so Leal is with Casa Leal. So, again,
she's going to be doing her ribbon cutting at that time, but she also wants to give back and support the community that helped make her. So it's incredible the fact that, you know, she wants to do it with an Easter focus to ensure that her community gets full Easter baskets. And it's going to be a great time with the DJs, with the food trucks, and just with all the events going on and the performances. It's going to be an awesome time.
It's going to be great. So there's, again, a lot of things to do in the weekend.
And then we're still, another thing that we touched on last week is, and it was spearheaded by Justin Martinez, our HR manager, we still have our food drive going on.
So the last day to collect donation is on the 13th. So come in, drive by the chamber, just a minute or two, drop out some food cans, some non-perishable food to help New Mexico and the people
and
we need.
The way that it works is this is going to go to Roadrunner Food Bank, and Roadrunner Food Bank feeds also and fills the other food banks around the state. Contributing to Roadrunner Food Bank and our box here at the chamber, that's going to help feed the entire state, not just Albuquerque.
Yes. And also, too, there's another event really exciting at one of the biggest B2B expos here in New Mexico. So
I had the privilege to have a booth there a few years ago when I was with Xerox, and it is an amazing, fun event. I can't wait for it. The B2B hosted by Exhibit. And that's going to be on the 18th
at the Isleta Resort and Casino. And we'll say it backwards, Isleta Casino and Resort.
There's still some sponsorship spots and vendor spots available. And how you can go about that is if you go to www.b2bexponm.com or you can call 505-828-0574. They're an amazing partner. We're excited to be part of the B2B. it's going to be an awesome time. There's going to be a lot of great vendors there. It's going to be great to be on either side of that.
So, and one of the nice things, like Kevin said, is B2B. It's not only B2B. It's not only business to business. It's also to business to consumers, too. So you just only looking to attend and walk around the booths, the vendors, get to know people, know what's going on, what kind of services, what kind of products are out there.
There's going to be lots of prizes too. There's even going to be like a little passport that you get where if you go to certain booths and you collect really all the passports, cool, and you get put in the running for some pretty big drawings.
So it's going to be exciting too. And talking about excitement, we have one exciting on the 26th, another Futures Fair coming in.
Which last year was the first year we started our Futures Fair.
So this is the second one. So Future Fair is kind of like a job fair, but kind of like a career fair.
Like it's a college fair, job fair, just pretty much future for your teenagers. So there's lots of different paths that people take once they graduate from college. Or graduate from high school. One of that's being going to college, going to a trade school, sometimes just going right into the workforce. So with this event, it's going to give a lot of different ideas and opportunities to see what's really going to drive. Like, is it the college? Is it the four-year college? Is it a trade school? What's the future holding? And hopefully this helps give it a little bit of clarity and points.
And it gives a lot of different options too for the kids. Like last year, we had some big government agencies. We had like DEA, we had the FBI, we have the Army, things like that. And then, for example, a lot of people knew, well, they thought that, oh, I want to work for the feds, but I need a 4-year college, I need a master's degree or something like that. And that's not the case.
I mean, there was definitely some eye popping, like, whoa, like if I go do this, if I do that, I could still work here at like the FBI. I could be working at Sandia Labs, like all of these different businesses and organizations that some of these kids already thought that they were eliminated from. And they really find out, like,
I just had one year of training. You still can work for a big company or a big organization, too. Also, too, we're going to have some unions. We're going to have a college, too. UNM, CNM is going to be there. Mm-hmm.
Just really, like, any scenario and how it plays out. That's what the Futures Fair is there for.
Exactly. So give it different options. And then after that, what we have?
May 4th. May the 4th be with you, Daniel. So we have our golf classic, which is going to be absolutely incredible. It's going to be a combination of, you know, Calaveras meets Star Wars with Cinco de Mayo the next day.
It's going to be really fun.
And 100% of the proceeds of this go to our scholarship fund. And last year, we were able to get over 100 kids' scholarships.
Yes.
So
anything between 1,000 to 5,500, different options. So we still have some teams available.
We have some teams and we have some sponsorships slots available.
If you would like to sponsor a hall, put your booth, your tent, and have some fun and network. And
we threw a lot at you today. We're going to be, you know, reminding you about the Futures Fair and the Golf Classics coming up. Don't sit on it, though. Just like Gala, these can sell out as well. So urgency, urgency, urgency. And we can't wait to see you at all the upcoming events that we just mentioned.
All right. Sounds good. So
from Daniel and Kevin, you guys have a great, happy Monday.
Have an awesome week. Take care.